Okay, here I have the presentation for reading, making predictions. Right now, do not copy. We're not going to copy right now. At the end, we're going to copy. So just have ready the notebook. The notebook, but right now, you don't have to copy anything. Right now. Okay, making predictions, as you can notice here, I have a picture that it says, I think in space, because, and then the space. So we're going to use this structure to look at here. Look at the pictures, class. Everybody look at the pictures, the four pictures, and tell me what's happening here. Can you describe what is happening here?
I think I'm playing. And the ball, put it in.
A boy is playing with the, is playing soccer and it's hitting the ball. And the ball is, it's
in the window.
And catch to the window.
Mm-hmm. It's soccer. This is the game. It's soccer class.
No, baseball. Baseball. Sorry.
Baseball. Baseball. He's using a bat and he's gonna hit the ball. The bat.
But the ball is gonna crash in the window.
Okay. And what do you think the final picture would show? The final picture here. What do you think will be here?
That the window is broke.
Okay. Using this. You try to use this. I think because.
I think that the window is going to be destroyed because the ball hit it.
Excellent. That's right. So you see, let's see. Yes, look at this. The last picture, you see, it's the prediction of Joshua. Joshua was saying and describing using the four pictures. He imagine what can happen then at the end using this information. I think the window will be broken because you know that the boy was hitting the ball with the bat, and that in the fourth picture, it was the ball in the direction of the window. So it's gonna be broken. Yes, excellent. So you see, it's a prediction. What is a prediction, class? A prediction is a guess. It's a guess that you make about something that might happen in the future. You think, maybe will happen this. I think that's going to happen this because you use the information that you have. It can be pictures or the keys that you have, clues, can be a word also. And then you imagine what can happen. You make a prediction of what will happen in the future. You can be right or not. So you can check your prediction. See here. We have, I predict because, it's the same, you can say, I think or I predict because. So let's read this part. Let's see, Rosa, help me to read this. Rosa, please.
Only the tracks playing in the mall and got a model. Marilyn was worried that Rex would get the house dirty. Marilyn's mom will not be happy about that.
Okay, excellent. So you see, what do you think will happen next? Which picture do you think is going to happen next after this? Marilyn let Rex play in the mood some more? Or Marilyn went across the street to play with her friend Carlos? Or do you think that Marilyn watched her dog Rex?
Marilyn watched her dog Rex.
Mm-hmm. The third one, Marilyn watched her dog Rex.
Okay, yes, I predict that Marilyn watched her dog Rex. Why? Because you see here that she was playing with the dog in the mood and got all moody, the dog. So it's obvious that your dog is not going to be moody all the day. So you are going to watch, it's going to take a bath. So then it's gonna be clean, right? So you see, we're making a prediction. We make a prediction using the information that we had on the text, that they were playing and the dog got moody. So it means that then we can predict that then is gonna take a bath, this dog, because Marilyn's mom would not be happy about that. Is when you're playing, it's the same when you're playing with your dog or with a friend and start raining, you're playing in the mud. You're not going to be muddy inside your house. What is going to say your mom? Go and take a shower, right? So it's the same with the dog. You take, the dog is not going to take the shower by itself. It needs some help. It needs our help. So we merely watch her dog Rex. That is the answer. Excellent. Now let's make a prediction, class. Remember, a prediction is a guess. You think what will happen next. Now, you can make a prediction just by using, look here, the cover of the page. We can make a prediction about the book without reading. We're not going to read this book. Just with the book, with the title, with the pictures, you can make your predictions. Read the title.
I think that the boy.
A boy has a pet dinosaur.
A pet dinosaur.
He'll have a lot of surprise.
Lost in the woods.
Mm-hmm. They can be lost in the woods, Gabriela.
And he's not brave. And then at the end of the story, it becomes brave, and that's why the title is Nighttime.
You already read the story.
Yes. No, why?
No? You are making your prediction, right? You're using just the title, the picture,
but that's a prediction. That's right.
Yes, Joshua. Look at here. He's using the information that he might think previous knowledge, maybe another book or another story. And now he's making a prediction. The prediction can be right, can be the same of the story. Joshua can be true. It can be the end of the story. Like, that.
I think a boy.
We're going to read the story, yes or no?
I know how a prediction of this story. I don't know.
You don't know? What do you think is going to be nighttime, class? You see the boy that he has a teddy bear, and what do you think is going to be? It's going to be about what? Someone different. No Joshua, no Rebecca, no Gabriela, because they already participate. Use your imagination, class. I see the picture and the title.
I think the boy and the dragon was best friend in one day in bed. But one night, the two boys, the dinosaur, the dragon and the boy, was perdido.
They were lost?
Were lost in the forest.
In the forest, yes.
The dragon and the boy was going to her house.
Okay, the boy and the dragon. There are not two boys. Okay, they were lost and they were going to the house.
What I say, what's true? I will read the story in a. I watched a video of that and it was the story.
Okay, perfect. Yeah, sometimes we can have a correct prediction and it's the same that happened, or sometimes we need to make some adjustment. Excellent. So you see here, just by reading the title, you can have an idea what the story can be about. Just by seeing the picture also, you can make your prediction. Now, predicting makes the reading interesting. Imagine that you are not predicting, you're just reading. You can use the title, you can use the cover, you can use even pictures just to predict. When you see the picture, some books they have pictures, you can say, I think that after this picture, something else is going to happen. So predicting makes interesting. So reading, it cannot be boring just by reading. You can stop and ask yourself questions or ask yourself, what can happen later? So look at this boy, he has a book, and it says, I predict that the text is going to be about nice castles in medieval times because the title said night times. This is the title of the book. So he says, it's going to be about castles, medieval times. In long time ago, the story might be written. I predict the text is going to have kings and queens. And then because there is a picture of the castle on the front cover, see? So you know that the stories that talked about queens and queens, they have castles. So it's a good prediction. I predict the text is going to be about fiction because it starts with once upon a time. All the fictions that they are, the story that they are not true, just in the imagination of the author, it's because they start once upon a time, there was a little baby. So it started this, they are fiction class. I predict the text is going to be set in the Middle Ages because I know that knights and castles were common at that time. So it was a long time ago. No, now you don't see castles, you don't see too much books about nice and castles and all this. Most of the books that were created and written in those times, in the medieval times, in Middle Ages. So I think, I predict, you can use I think or I predict, and you make your prediction, because using the information that you have. Using the cover, it can help you. This boy, all the prediction of this boy is just by using the cover page. The cover page, the picture, the title, and the first paragraph maybe, because it says once upon a time. Just by reading that, it makes a prediction. So you don't need to read everything to make a prediction. Since the beginning, you can make a prediction class. Now, let's watch, we're going to watch this video. Let me open it here. So pay attention to this video. Okay. Here it is.
I just checked out a book from the library. Hey, where'd my book go? I wonder where he went.
Okay, class, that was the video. That was the video about that's making predictions, class, making predictions. Okay, did you see that presentation one more time? Just let me.
Yeah.
Yes? Okay, perfect. Now, remember on the video was describing also that you make predictions just by reading the title when you are reading, and after reading, you check your prediction. Now, in your notebook, we're going to copy this. This is the summary. It's the only thing that we're going to copy today. Making prediction, the meaning of what is a prediction. You can, if you want to
draw.
Yes, if you want to draw, if you want to decorate like this, it's okay. Yes, if you want to draw. Yes, if you want to decorate like this, so beautiful or better, you can do
copy
it.
This.
Yes,
maybe copy we this. Have to copy all this.
All the information, yes. If you want to make the drawings, it's okay. A prediction, number one, it's a prediction, it's a guess, remember. It's a guess that you make by using the text or the pictures as clues to help you. So clues are here. If you want to draw, it's okay. I think because you use this phrase, or we can use the phrase, I predict, because it's okay. There is no like a phrase that we use. We can use this phrase, or I predict because, it's okay. One step, we have three steps. Before, during, and after reading. Before reading, you look at the title and the illustration. Look at this, bad apple. So you just by reading the title and the illustration, you might have an idea what it can be this story about. During the reading is the second step. You start reading the story and then you stop. You stop and you make your predictions. What will happen next? Maybe the apple is gonna become a good apple. Maybe the king is gonna be fighting with different animals, different dragons. Maybe the princess is going to escape because she wants to have a new life. Well, you start predicting. You start predicting using pictures, using titles. So you stop. Then you continue reading. And after reading, you confirm or adjust your prediction. When you're finished to read, you check if your predictions were right. Were you right? Yes, so you confirm. Like Joshua, Joshua can say, oh, I said the same that it was happening in the story, or no, it's not the same that I say. My prediction was not the same that that happened at the end, but this is what happened. So you use the information that you have now. So copy this. If you want to draw, it's okay. If you want to decorate it, it's okay. Now, in reading, today, you don't have homework in reading. This book, you don't have homework in reading class. So I'm going to take the attendance while you copy this in your notebook. Say present if you are connected, class. Ana, Andrea, and Camila. No Ana, no Andrea, no Camila.
Present.
Okay, Camila is here. Gabriela, Isabella, and Kiara.
Present.
Present.
Perfect. Lucía, Mía, and Rebeca.
Present.
Mía, Valentina. Elmia, Rosa, Valerie, and Sian.
Present.
Valerie and Sian, it's up here. Okay, Alberto, Dani, and Fernando.
Present.
Present.
Hermes, Joshua, and Khaled.
Present.
Marcelo, Santiago Hernandez, and Santiago Chavez.
Present.
Okay, excellent. Just Santiago
Hernandez. And I have the Lola, 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 Lola.
You have Lola with you. Okay.
Is he sleeping? Está durmiendo mi cuya.
Okay. Better, better. So you cannot be playing with her. So she's sleeping and you are writing in your notebook. See, yeah, good job. You're drawing. Excellent. Dani, Camila, are you working?
Yes, miss.
Yes,
yes, miss.
Okay. I have only 4 minutes to write all these.
Yes, 4 minutes, 4 minutes to copy this. It's not too much. It looks like you have to copy too much, but it's not too much. The decoration, the drawings, but it's not too much.
Miss, I finished to do all and I draw, but I don't have right now my colors, but I, in the house, I go to color all.
Okay, yeah. Perfect. Yes, you can color it later. Okay, good job, Rebecca. If you finish the copy, you are dismissed, so you can go and have your lunch. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Miss?